AMD, why do you have to make things so confusing? You do realize that the average IQ of a person who buys your products is inversely proportional to how much money they spend on it. So why on earth did you complicate things by having 3 chipsets this time for the AM5 socket instead of 2? And when you all just simply accepted that X670 Extreme is just something we have to live with, like climate change, AMD dropped a bombshell on us. There's also a B650 Extreme. So that's right, there are 4 different chipsets you can buy for your upcoming Ryzen 7000 based build. But what exactly is the big difference between B650E and B650? Well, B650E will feature a PC Gen 5 slot for your graphics card. And that's it. No, that's not a joke. That is literally the only difference, as presented by this beautiful little chart provided by Anantech. Or rather, that's almost it. Naturally, more high-end motherboards also have better features, like for example more VRMs, better rear I/O, and more. So you can expect B650E boards to have better features than the B650 counterparts. Or you could have just gone for an X670 instead. Naturally, all this means is that these motherboards are all gonna have pretty similar features. However, there is a silver lining. Seeing how the B650 chipset just costs less to implement, motherboard manufacturers will be able to cut costs a bit and in turn provide a cheaper motherboard that has a PC Gen 5 16X slot for a lower price than X670. So if that's all you're after, then hey, good for you, Christmas has come early. You got all that? Good, because it's about to get even more confusing. And that's all thanks to Gigabyte, because they recently announced, or rather teased, that the upcoming Gigabyte Tachyon, motherboard is going to use B650, or more likely now B650E, rather than an X670 chipset. Now if you don't know, these are the premium overclocking motherboards that provide uncompromised features for overclocking potential. So if that's the case, why on earth aren't they gonna go for X670? Well, odds are that B650E will actually be better at taking your CPUs to the extremes in the way that Gigabyte envisions for these Tachyon boards. Not to mention, it looks like B650E will also play nicer with the fact that these Tachyon boards only have 2 DIMM slots on them. Yeah, that's right, only 2 DIMM slots. So in theory, this step down chipset should be able to support these features much better. So yeah, it looks like the battle between which chipset is truly the best is going to be a very, very complicated one indeed. So yeah, thanks for that one, AMD. No, but seriously, thank you, AMD. I'm going to milk this motherboard content as much as possible on my channel. So if you're going to be saving a few dollars by buying a B650E motherboard instead of an X670, why not spend it on something more awesome, like for example, this t-shirt, which is going to be down in our merch store in the video description below. Down there, you're going to find a Patreon if you want to support the channel that way. And I'd also like to thank my extinct patrons, Gavin Burns, Ryan, Elevroniak, LKB, Mexum, Nushin, Allcroft, Lansby, and Jesse Herbman. Thank you guys so much, support truly goes a long way. Down there you can find our Amazon links, our Discord server, and our social media links as well. But anyway, that's about it, so I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, then remember to subscribe, like, whatever, and I'll see you all in whatever I make next. Goodbye everyone, goodbye.